إذا ندرس الآن أسباب سجود السهو. نعم.
And therefore now we're going to study the different reasons why a person should make sujood al-sahw, the sujood of forgetfulness.
أسباب سجود السهو ثلاثة.
The reasons why a person has to make sujood al-sahw, the prostration of forgetfulness, is three. The three reasons.
الزيادة.
Somebody adds something to the prayer.
سهوا.
Out of forgetfulness.
والنقص يعني ترك شيئا من الأركان أو من الواجبات سهوا.
A person leaves something from the prayer in forgetfulness, i.e. a person forgets to do a pillar or an obligation.
والثالث الشك.
And then the third reason is somebody doubting, a doubt that happens.
إذن أسباب سجود السهو ثلاثة. الزيادة والنقص والشك.
So therefore, the reasons or the causes for a person to prostrate the sujood al-sahw, the prostration of forgetfulness, are three. Adding something to the prayer in forgetfulness, taking something away or leaving off something in the prayer out of forgetfulness, and a person doubting something.
الزيادة.
As for an addition,
لو زاد في صلاة القام في صلاة الظهر إلى الركعة الخامسة.
If a person adds something to the prayer, so for example, in the Dhuhr prayer, a person stands up and he starts reading a fifth unit of prayer.
لو تعمد القيام الخامسة فالصلاة باطلة.
If a person gets up for the fifth unit of prayer in Dhuhr and he does this on purpose, then the whole prayer is invalid.
نسي وقام إلى الخامسة فالصلاة صحيحة، لكن يجب عليه متى انتبه وعلم أنه في الخامسة أن يرجع مباشرة. نعم.
If a person forgets and stands up for a fifth time in the Dhuhr prayer, which is four units, and he does this out of forgetfulness, then his prayer is correct.
But
as soon as once a person has stood up, as soon as he remembers that this is now a fifth unit, then he sits down straight away.
نعم. يرجع مباشرة ويسجد للسهو والصلاة صحيحة.
So straight away he goes back down. And then he makes the prostration of forgetfulness and the prayer is correct.
الثاني النقص يعني ترك شيئا من صلاته. نعم.
And then the second reason or cause for sujood al-sahw is a naqs. A person forgetting or leaving to not doing something.
نعم. النقص إما أن يكون للأركان أو للواجبات أو للسنن.
And a person leaving off something or not doing something out of forgetfulness will either be in one of the pillars, i.e. leaving off a pillar from the pillars of the prayer, or leaving off an obligation of the prayer, or leaving off and not doing a recommended act in the prayer.
فلو ترك ركن من أركان الصلاة فالصلاة باطلة سواء كان متعمد أو جاهل أو ناسي.
If a person doesn't perform a pillar of the prayer, then his prayer is invalid. This is regardless of whether he leaves off performing the pillar, remembering out of forgetfulness, knowing or not knowing.
إذا لا يقبل في ترك الركن أو الشرط جهل أو نسيان أو عمد.
And therefore, a person not performing a pillar in the prayer, and we've already mentioned the pillars, whether the person is ignorant or forgetful, or whether he did it out of intent, then this is not accepted.
ترك قراءة الفاتحة.
So for example, if a person leaves off reciting the Fatiha, he doesn't recite the Fatiha in the prayer.
فالصلاة باطلة.
Then the prayer is invalid.
بلا تفصيل جاهل أو ناسي أو متعمد.
And this is without any detail or with any excuse.
نعم. نسي قراءة الفاتحة في الركعة الأولى.
A person forgets to recite Surah Al-Fatiha in the first prayer.
وتذكر في الركعة الثانية أنه لم يقرأ في الأولى الفاتحة.
But he remembers in the second unit of prayer, in the second rak'ah, he remembers that in the first rak'ah I didn't recite the Fatiha.
عندنا قاعدة.
Then we have a principle.
كل شيء وقع بعد ترك الركن فهو لاغي. لا يحسب.
That every action or every unit of prayer that a person does after leaving off one of the pillars, like Surah Al-Fatiha, then those actions are not accepted. They are not accepted.
يرجع إلى مكان ترك الركن ويأتي به.
Rather, a person then has to go back to the pillar that he didn't do.
ثم يتم الأولى ثم يصلي الثانية وعلى هذا. إذا كل شيء بعد ترك الركن فهو لاغ، فلابد أن أرجع إلى المكان الذي ترك فيه الركن ويبدأ من هنا من جديد. نعم.
So a person who forgot or didn't do this pillar in one of the units of the prayer, everything that he has done since that time, it becomes invalid. So what does that person have to do? As soon as he remembers, he goes back to the pillar which he didn't do. And then he does that pillar, and then he carries on from that unit. So if he left off the pillar at the first unit of the prayer, then he starts from the first unit again, and does the second and third, and completes the prayer.
نعم. الثاني ترك واجب من واجبات الصلاة.
And also a person might leave out of forgetfulness an obligation from the obligations of the prayer.
فإذا تعمد ترك الواجب فالصلاة باطلة.
So if a person does this with intent on purpose, then the prayer is invalid.
كان جاهلا أو ناسيا بوجوب هذا الواجب في الصلاة فالصلاة صحيحة.
But if a person does it out of forgetfulness, i.e. forgets to do a particular obligation, or a person doesn't know that this obligation is an obligation, then the prayer is correct.
فإذا انتقل من مكان هذا الواجب لا يرجع إليه واسجد للسهو.
So once the person has now left this obligation and he's left that position where he should have done the obligation, then now he doesn't have to go back and fulfill this obligation again. Rather, he completes the prayer, the rest of the prayer, and then makes to do the sahu, the prostration of forgetfulness.
وإن لم ينتقل من مكان الواجب أتى به ثم أكمل بقية الصلاة.
And if a person hasn't yet left the place or the position of that obligation, then he says the obligation, he performs the obligation and the rest of the prayer.
في صلاة المغرب لم يجلس للتشهد الأول وقام للركعة الثالثة.
For example, in the Maghrib prayer, the person, he didn't sit in order to recite the first tashahud. He stood up straight away.
التشهد الأول واجب من واجبات الصلاة.
We said that the first tashahud, that the first tashahud in a prayer which is 3 units or 4 units, it is an obligation from the obligation of the prayer.
فماذا يصنع هنا؟ انتقل من مكان الواجب لا يرجع إليه ويسجد للسهو والصلاة صحيحة لأنه ناسي. نعم. أما إذا تعمد فالصلاة باطلة. نعم.
So what does he do here? Once he has stood up and forgotten the first tashahud, he carries on. He carries on praying his 3rd unit of the prayer, and then after fulfilling the prayer makes sujood the sahu and his prayer is correct.
نسي وهو في التشهد الأول نسي وبدأ أن يقول التحيات لله قال الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مثلا. نعم.
Or a person, the first tashahud, he forgets the first tashahud. And while sitting in the position, instead of saying the first tashahud, he starts saying Surah Al-Fatiha.
وتذكر وهو جالس الآن ماذا يصنع؟
But while sitting down and while reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, then he remembers that he has forgotten to say التشهد.
نقول أقرأ التشهد الآن والحمد لله رب العالمين. نعم.
All he does is he says the التشهد and everything is okay.
الثالث من النقص في الصلاة ترك سنة من سنة الصلاة. فلو ترك سنة من سنة الصلاة كأن ترك مثلا دعاء استفتاح فالصلاة صحيحة لكن ينقص أجر الصلاة. نعم.
And if a person doesn't perform a sunnah, i.e. something which is recommended inside the prayer, then his prayer is correct, however deficient in reward. For example, if a person in his prayer forgets to recite the dua istiftah, subhanakallahumma bihamdik, then his prayer is correct and he doesn't need to repeat it again, but his prayer is deficient in reward.
Yeah. إذن هذا هو القسم الثاني النقص في الصلاة.
And therefore this is the second type of sujood al-sahu, which is making or performing the sujood al-sahu due to a deficiency or due to not doing something.
النقص للأركان سهوا لابد أن يأتي بالركن وما بعد الركن ويسجد للسهو.
So as for a person making sujood al-sahu for missing a pillar, then a person has to say that perform the pillar again, the rukun again, and make sujood al-sahu.
أما ترك الواجب إذا انتقل من مكان هذا الواجب فالصلاة صحيحة والسجود السهو وإن لم ينتقل أتى به. نعم.
And as for a person forgetting to do an obligation, then if he has moved from that position now, then he fulfills his prayer and he makes sujood al-sahu. If he's still in that position, he says the obligation and then carries on with the prayer.
القسم الثالث من أسباب سجود السهو.
And now the third reason for a person performing sujood sahwi.
الشك.
Is a person doubting something.
عندنا الشك في كل العبادات ينقسم إلى قسمين. في الصلاة وفي الطهارة وفي الوضوء وفي الطواف وفي السعي وفي كل عبادة.
The doubts that we have in any worship, whether it's a doubt in the prayer, whether it's a doubt in wudu, whether it's a doubt in tahara and purification or any aspect of worship, then the doubts are two types.
أن يكون الشك بعد الفراغ والانتهاء من العبادة فهذا لا يلتفت إليه إطلاقا.
Is that once a person has finished the act of prayer, finished the act of worship, then a doubt comes in his mind. Finished the act of worship, and now shaitan comes with a doubt in his mind. In this situation, he doesn't look to this doubt at all. He doesn't consider this doubt at all.
حتى ولو كان هذا الشك 99.9% لا يلتفت إليه.
Even if a person doubts something, 99.9% he doubts that he hasn't done something, for example. Even in that situation, you don't turn to it at all, as long as you've completed the act of worship.
صلى الآن صلاة العصر.
So for example, a person prays the Asr prayer.
ثم الآن قال والله أشك 90% أنني لم أقرأ الفاتحة الثانية.
And now, you know, almost 1.5 hours later, a person says that I am 95% sure that I didn't recite Surah Al-Fatiha. 95% sure.
انتهت الصلاة.
Has the prayer finished?
لو رجع فهو آثم.
If now he goes back and starts praying the prayer again, then he's sinning.
طاف بالبيت.
A person makes tawaf around the Kaaba.
أشواط سبعة.
All seven units.
وصلى ركعتين. سنة الطواف.
And after doing the tawaf seven times, he prays the two raka'at behind Maqam Ibrahim. He prays the two raka'at.
ثم عندما أراد الذهاب إلى السعي شك هل طاف سبعة أشواط أو أقل.
And then after this, once this person wants to go and make sa'i between Safa and Marwa, then this person doubts. He has a doubt. Did I do the seventh tawaf or not?